Hello friends, today I'm starting my last Inco term, that is DDP, Delivered Duty Paid. And we all know that this Inco terms 2020 started in this year in January 2020. In my previous slides, I've explained to you all the Inco terms very clearly. My name is Humaira. I retired from State Bank. I regularly take sessions for CDCS participants, bankers from all around the globe. I give online coaching for all the documentary credit specialists who would appear for the exam conducted by LIBF, London Institute of Banking and Finance. I'm happy to share with you that I have launched my website, Success to CDCS. You can visit the website. You get all the video recordings of the chapters, 25 chapters of CDCS. And I've given the PowerPoint presentations too. You can find the basket and the simulation questions, examination of documents, and have a number of practice tests. This gives you the confidence and the success to CDCS. Meanwhile, I thought I will share with you the Incoterms 2020 in the YouTube. So, these Incoterms stand for International Commercial Terms brought out by ICC. This started in January 2020, to Incoterms 2020. You can see on the left side, the exporter is in Beijing, China, and the right side you find the importer. Now, when the importer imports, there is a lot of process involved. The inland transportation from the exporter's warehouse to the port, the customs duties, then the main ocean freight or the air freight or the road rail freight charges, again the customs at the importer's country, inland transportation to his destination. So these Incoterms are defined based on the delivery points. So the main delivery point, you have three important things to consider. That is the cost, risk and responsibility. So where the responsibility shifted from the seller to the buyer. So based on these delivery points, 11 Incoterms have been defined. So Incoterms talk about the obligations related to the buyer and seller, the risk, the cost, which party is responsible for costs like packing, loading charges, security related, original terminal charges, unloading, again the customs, import duty and taxes. And where is the responsibility shifted from the seller to the buyer? Based on these delivery points, we find 11 Incoterms. And in the exporting country, you can find there are 4 Incoterms in the slide. A letter E for ex work and 3 letters with F. Free carrier, FCA. Free alongside ship, FAS. Free on board, FOB. Then in the main carriage, you will find 4 Incoterms with the letter C. CFR, cost and freight. CIF, cost, insurance and freight. CPT, carriage paid to. CIP, carriage and insurance paid to. And in the import destination country, you have 3 Incoterms with the letter D. Delivered at place, unloaded, delivered duty paid. Now, one more thing you can see in this slide. There are 4 Incoterms in red. FAS, FOB, CFR and CI. But the word port is written there, which shows that it is for ocean transport. And the remaining Incoterms on the left side in green, you can see the word place, ex work, free carrier, carriage paid to, carriage and insurance paid to, delivered at place, unloaded, delivered at place, delivered duty paid. So these are the 11 Incoterms we have spoken about. And today we are in the last Incoterm, DDP, Delivered Duty Paid. I think by the term itself, we are able to understand something. Let's see what it is. Now you see the exporter is in Beijing, China, left side. Right side you find the importer in Pune. And let us say we are importing 100 printers. How are we going to go about with this Incoterm if we incorporate it in our MT-700. DDP can be used for any mode of transport. It could be by sea, it could be by air, it could be by road, it could be by rail. So it could be used for any mode of transport. Now the seller is responsible for transporting the goods to the named place. First criteria, seller is responsible for transporting the goods to the named place, including customs clearance, import duty taxes in the destination country. Until the goods are ready for unloading, it is not unloaded. Only in DPU is the only Incoterm where goods are unloaded, delivered at place, unloaded. But here in DDP, only one area where the seller does not do anything is he only sees that the goods are ready for unloading. So the buyer is responsible for unloading at Pune warehouse. So seller delivers the goods at the agreed place, at destination. So seller's obligation is to clear the goods in the importer's country, paying all the import duty taxes, VAT, whatever taxes are there, customs, and pay everything. So how do we write this Incoterm? We will write 100 printers DDP. Let us say XYZ warehouse, Pune, India, Incoterms 2020. This is how you will write it in the field 45A. So DDP, from the word itself, we will know that the seller is having the maximum responsibility to deliver at the place, named place, agreed place at the destination and clear the goods, paying all the customs clearance, import duty taxes, VAT, everything. But only it is ready for unloading at the warehouse in Pune. So the seller, what are the things does he does? Let us sum up. In his warehouse, he does the packing. He will load it on the inland transport. He will bring it to the port or an airport or seaport or to the place. Then he will pay all the customs charges. There may be a freight forwarder who is handling the logistics, his charges. Then he will pay the ocean freight, air freight or road rail freight. After reaching Mumbai port, he will also pay the customs, unloading charges, import duty taxes, destination terminal charges. So the maximum responsibility for the seller is in DDP, delivered duty paid. And so we learn in D term. D term, we have three, DAP, DPU, DDP. And D terms are always for the importing country, place of destination. In DAP, it was delivered to door only, delivered at place. In DPU, it was delivered to door and unloaded. In DDP, delivered to door, unloaded duties and taxes paid by all seller. But it was ready for unloading. Ready for unloading. So thank you.